He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Hey guys, for today's practice problem, we have these two dihalides. We have these two vicinal dihalides, and we want to notice that they differ in their stereochemistry. And what we want to do is we want to start from an alkyne, and we want to show the pathway to get to these two different vicinal dihalides. So think about the reactions you know that can do this kind of chemistry, and give this a shot. Okay, we know we have to start from an alkyne. That is our designated starting material. And we know that we're trying to get these dihalides. And so certainly a reaction that ideally is going to come to mind is dihalogenation, right? That is definitely one way we know to get dihalides, and specifically vicinal, because we know in a dihalogenation we're going to get two halogens and they're going to be on adjacent carbons. That's just how that reaction works. So dihalogenation is something we want to be able to do, but we need to start from an alkyne. We know how to get from an alkene to one of these. So let's see what we can do. We're looking at this here. This is a very straightforward situation because we know that dihalogenation, we know that the halogens are added in anti-fashion. And if you want to go back to that tutorial, you can see why the stereochemistry works like that. But this is exactly the molecule that is going to come from just the alkene as drawn, right? We know that we can get that from this. And remember, this is a retrosynthetic arrow. It means back in time. So we're not saying we're going to do this reaction. We're saying that back in time to this, because from this we can get that. That is just a regular dihalogenation with Br2, and that's how that's going to work. And so, but we want to start from an alkyne. So we've got an alkene. Do we know ways to get from alkynes to alkenes? We actually do. Remember, we had that tutorial where we talked about different ways to go selectively from the alkyne to the alkene. So we know that this is a valid retrosynthetic step. So we're going to be able to go from the butyne. We're going to be able to do this. So that's our two-step situation. So what the thing is, now we need to say what reagents we're going to use to do this. So starting with the butyne, how can we selectively go from this alkyne to the E alkene? Remember, this is an E alkene because these methyls are going on in opposite directions with respect to the plane of the pi bond. And so what was the reagent there? We knew that we could run this. It was sodium and ammonia. There was an analogous situation using lithium. It was always one of these sodium or lithium situations, and depending on what you're doing in class, you may prefer one over the other. We know that that is going to allow us to get to the E alkene, right? So that we had to remember because there's stereospecificity involved there. And then just regular dihalogenation. So we might do that in CCl4, but certainly Br2, that is going to get us to this one. So we are all set with that. This is our pathway to get to that. We're going to go from the alkyne, we're going to selectively go to the E alkene, and then we're going to do dihalogenation. So, but let's look over here. It's not going to work as well for this, because if we did dihalogenation to this guy, we're going to get this, not this. These actually have different stereochemistries, and that is relevant. So what if we just do one thing? How about we just do this? Let's just rotate this. Let's rotate this 180 degrees. So that means, let's draw that a little better. So let's say we keep that there, and then what we've done is we've flipped this like this. So this methyl is still in the plane there, but if this is still in the plane, that wedge bond, right, that got rotated all the way back to the dash. So that is now on the dash. Right. So this looks a little bit better, because from here, since we know that dihalogenation, the halogens are added in anti-fashion, now this is in a conformation that looks like it's more readily going backwards to get to the alkene that we want. Right? This is now a valid retrosynthetic step, because if we start from this alkene and we do dihalogenation, we are going to get this stereochemistry. And once again, if we rotate this bond, we are going to get that in that conformation that looks a little more familiar. So we can go backwards to this. And then from here, again, we do know that we have a way to get there from the alkyne. Right, so what was our way to do that? So let's say we're starting with our alkyne. How do we go forwards now, right? We made our retrosynthetic pathway. Now we want to go forward. Starting from the alkyne, what are we going to do? To get from here to the Z alkene, what was our way of doing that? That was our Lindler's catalyst. And so you can memorize those conditions, or you can maybe even just write Lindler. And so Lindler, we know, is going to get us to the Z alkene. And then from there, now we can just perform dihalogenation. So we can do regular dihalogenation, and that is going to get us to here. Right, so that was our situation here, and we know that this is just another conformation of this, and so we have shown the two ways of getting the desired stereochemistry on the dihalide product, and the key centered around these stereospecific transformations from the alkyne to the alkene, going preferentially to E or Z, respectively. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.